safety. And today they're going to share with us how they have shared love for God by sharing love for our neighbors. And I think that you're in for a treat. So let's sing together our theme scripture for this worship series, which is Micah 6:8. Say it with me. The Lord has told you what is required of you, to do justice, to love kindness, and to walk humbly with your God. Here's what you can expect in worship today. We'll begin by singing a hymn and a song together. There will not be a separate children's worship. We want the kids to stay and experience what our youth have to share.
To recap, it says we will serve alongside our neighbors by joining Jesus in caring for those who are poor, sick, lonely, mistreated, or marginalized. And we just heard the scripture from Proverbs. Whoever brings blessing will be enriched, and one who waters will himself be watered. Well, church, we got watered this week. We got to, not literally, usually it storms on us this week, not as much, well, last night. Anyway, we got to do some really good stuff. We got to feel God move through our work. We started every day with a little bit of worship and scripture on this untrip. We worked on some concepts behind serving and watched for God to move around us and through us. It was a great way to spend some time together, to reconnect with some people and build connections with others. But I know you don't want to hear my take on it, so we're going to hear from some of our awesome youth in just a minute. Please know that everyone in these fancy purple shirts was integral to our work and worship this week, including Mark, who refused to wear his fancy purple shirt. So he may give it to you, but I don't know. Anyway, take it away. But before we start hearing from our youth, and our first one up will be Miranda, so there's my cue, we are going to sing a new song. It is called Child of Love, and it is by a group called We the Kingdom. And if you listen to any Christian stations, you probably know it. We love it, and we encourage you to have fun with it.
Let's dance. Why should we do mission work? For even the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many. Mark 10:45. Day one was about why we went to do mission work, and the actual work of the day was about food. These are topics we can all relate to. The scripture I just read says that Jesus came to our world not to be served, but to serve others. So it seems pretty clear that we, as we try to become more Christ-like in our faith journey, we should, in fact, try and serve others. So we went to the Mid-Ohio Food Collective in Grove City and sorted and sanitized all kinds of donations, which went on a big conveyor belt and to be boxed for distribution. It was a huge facility, and we worked with many other volunteers. It was fun, and it went really fast. We saw God move through us in many, many boxes that got packed during our time. We saw God in the other people who showed up to work and were so kind to us newcomers and others. We saw God in our laughter and debates and growing relationships. Serving God by helping feed God's children helped us too.
Abundantly, so that in all things at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good work. As it is written, they have freely scattered their gifts to the poor, their righteousness endures forever. That's 2 Corinthians 9:7-9. Day two was about attitude and clothing, which sometimes feels like they go together. The attitude we were going for, as the scripture says, cheerful. We did our special basketball cheer. Especially motivated to look for kids and nicer clothing for teens. Though, to be honest, there were very few good quality items for the in the 20 or 30 bags we sorted. Lots of women's and men's, but not much for the under 18 crowd. It made me think about my own clothes and that I can sort through them and maybe take some extras to the free store. They actually give away everything instead of using donations as a fundraiser like other organizations do. My pro tip, when you donate, label the bag with the type and season of the clothing. An example would be girls size 8, size 10, some. I didn't actually take any clothes with me on Friday, but I realized that by being there, we lightened the load for the regular volunteers and the workers and allowed them to focus on other side projects that often get shelved. We saw God in every face that came shopping that day. We saw God in one of us taking cash to donate and giving it to the coordinator of Desiree, who already knew a need for the cash and would help them tremendously. We saw God in the steady flow of donations that came in the back door throughout our time there. We saw God in the very kind thank you we were given as we left that matched Carrie's initial message of being cheerful in our work. God is good.
All the time.
It was so nice to serve with our neighbors and for them from other parts of Columbus.
Feed the hungry and help those in trouble. Then let your light shine out from the darkness, and the darkness around you will be as bright. bright as noon. Isaiah chapter 58, verse 10. Yesterday we went three different locations for our work, and it was hard work. The Bethel crew rebuilt the fire pit here at Bethel so that many groups and our neighbors can use it easily and safely. We washed a lot of windows and did a lot of decor work in the senior high room. The other crew organized and cleaned and moved stuff at the restore location on Westerville Road in the morning and then moved to Bethel Road location for the afternoon. We all had lunch and youth-led devotion times at our sites. The restore crew was put on door duty at for our whole shift at the Bethel Road location. We moved about 1,100 doors and organized them and fixed up that whole section for the restore. The Goliath door. That thing was huge. The serve in yesterday's work, as it did all week and working behind the scenes to help actually hand it. The serve in yesterday's work, as it did all week and working behind the scenes to help other things happen more easily or become more accessible in the future. You know, we never actually handed food out to anyone, but we did make sure it was safe and easy to find.
I'm Ben. I know I said it earlier, but I figured it.
I'm Ben.
So we didn't take any clothes to the food store, but we organized to display what they had to make it more accessible to those in need of clothing. And we didn't build a house. Apparently Bob, the awesome Habitat Build leader for our area, didn't think that pouring concrete and driving the cement truck would be exactly a great idea for us. Although, I mean, we could have done it. We were not
well. We could have done it.
But we did make it easier for shoppers at two restore locations to find good quality stuff to buy so funds could be raised for future homes. And the staff of the Bethel Restore told us that they've been needing to handle the out-of-control door situation a lot. But they just don't have big enough groups all that often to have something to be able to handle something like that. We were able to handle the task that should have taken them, that would have taken them too much time to keep the store running. We learned that serving is often behind the scenes, often random, and that God perfectly equipped all of us to do the tasks that needed to be done this weekend. We saw God within our group and in how our group impacted the people who are working to care for those who are poor, sick, lonely, mistreated, or marginalized every day.
We circle back to today's scripture that talks about who can actually do mission work, and I mean the scripture that I set for the trip a long time ago, the trip. Each one should use whatever gift he has received to serve others, faithfully administering God's grace in its various forms. That's 1 Peter 4:10. Our amazing God has used every single one of us in mission work this week, from the 8th graders to the recent graduates to the AP youth. That's, they named themselves Advanced Placement Youth, and so that's hilarious. Anyway. To the AP youth who helped with music, to the old advisors, and maybe even old hip hop. We're the teacher. All right, anyway. we're all different, unique children of God with varied backgrounds and different experiences within this church. Some of them have been brought up here, carried in those car seats by their parents when they were babies, right? Some only set foot in this church earlier this year for the very first time for sunshine because a friend was like, you gotta do sunshine. Some have lived close by for years and others have only recently moved into Columbus. Some of us have been at every youth event we could get to before and during this pandemic, and others have been less involved for any number of reasons. Some of us have jobs and others are students. We all have different gifts and graces. Some are musical, others not as much. Some are creative types, others need a blueprint. Some are driven workers, and others need a little extra motivation. The point is, God knows us all, sees us all, and calls us all. So the answer to who can serve? We can all serve, just as our new vision statement says. And repeating that, it says, we will serve alongside our neighbors by joining Jesus in caring for those who are poor, sick, lonely, mistreated, or marginalized. We're going to try to address the lonely part of it later on today in our mission work that we're going to do while at Sue Hapton's house in between dips in the pool, frankly. We're making love rocks, and there's just going to be, you'll see some of them. It's just going to be little spots of brightness and color and joy and reminder oversees it, the rock where we find one, there'll be a lot, will be reminded they're precious children of God too. We are so lucky that we all got to respond to God's call together this week. We grew closer to each other and closer to God. And you can too. Why? Because our God is good.
All the time.
Obviously. So I want to take a moment to recognize some people. This will be the crying part. Just everyone take a breath. It's going to be fun. We're going to get through it together. I want to take a moment to recognize some people who have been serving God alongside all these youth and many others for a long, long time. There's a popular saying, it takes a village to raise a child. Well, it takes a strong set of reliable volunteers to keep a youth program safe, joyful, and growing. That's for sure. I would like to ask Scott, Guy, and Jen to come stand up here so you can stare at them while I talk about them.
Yeah.
Raise your hand if you were even born. Pumps. Okay, I'm just kidding. He was instrumental in getting the youth involved in Reffing Upward. He was always very generous with his time, especially in the summer when we started doing week-long stay-away mission trips. I can honestly say that I'm not sure we could have done any out-of-state trips without him. He also has worked to continue taking youth to Belize in February when that trip works. After Pastor Mike and I conspired to get youth on that international mission trip years ago. It's pretty cool. So, Greg, I hope you watch this, and so thank you. Jesse Rice said yes to helping youth the same year that Guy Shopkins would claim that I bullied him into it. She stepped away the year before COVID changed everything, before COVID changed everything anyway, due to wanting to have some more control over her weekends, needed to be out of town. Jesse was always a flexible, calm presence and had a great way of asking questions that youth wanted to ask but didn't know how to phrase. She's who got us hooked on Clay's Water Park for our water retreat we did that one time, and which I believe that our rising seniors have already impressed Jalen, wherever Jalen is. Hey, Jalen. I believe they've already talked to you about that. I know Jalen's excited. Yeah. So, Jesse, thank you so much. Thank you so much. All right. Now we're to the ones in the room. Scott McPhail has been a jack of all services. All service trades here at Bethel. I mean, he has always shown a passion for helping out wherever needed and whenever needed, especially as it applied to children and youth. Scott is that go-to volunteer when I want to do something, but the details that kind of bog me down. Like when we're doing a car wash, he's like, "Oh, I've got a hose splitter. I've got 47 extra towels. I'll just bring them." And I'm like, "Oh, thank you, perfect." Or like when I'm on a bonfire, he's like, "Well, I'll build a fire," and I go out there and it's already built. Look, oh, thank you. That's awesome. So. Scott, thank you for always taking a load of details off my plate so I can be more in the spirit instead of the minutia. I appreciate that. Guy Shopkins has been a servant in this church practically since he started attending a couple of decades ago. I'm significantly younger than Guy. Over a year. His humor and complete willingness to be silly have made him a huge hit with children's ministries and more recently with our youth. He is often picked to be a confirmation mentor, and it's been a pleasure to watch him nurture the youth of Bethel. Thank you, Guy. Should we clap? I think we should clap. And let's retro clap for Scott. And Jen Herring has been so, so faithful to our youth for such a long time.
It's okay.
She was able to start and sustain a small group for youth on the west side of town when I separated small groups geographically. And then again, when I changed small groups into to be gender-specific small groups, she still had a group going the whole time. Her attention to detail and her reliability have made her a top-notch volunteer advisor. She's been on mission trips. She has wordsmithed the bulletin for sunrise services. She's remembered to check in with the group chat weekly. Her dedication to youth has been inspiring and so important over the years. Jen, thank you so much for everything you've done with you. everybody the year, the 2 years that before that, the very first talent show fundraiser that we did. And when we did that fundraiser, in case you're not remembering, that goes to the free store Christmas shop that they do. And so it's a really important one to do. 2 years before the synchro, they agreed they did the 12 days of Christmas, and it was no one died, so that was exciting. That was exciting. Yeah. Good job, Jen. All right. So the answer to who can serve? Still, pretty much anybody doing anything, right? Which is what I've asked of them, so thank you guys. You guys all may or may not be aware that it's my custom, don't go anywhere yet, to send off our seniors. Good try, Jennifer. I usually send our seniors off with their very own Shutterfly books filled with photos of all our great times together to help our seniors remember how cherished and precious and beloved they are. And that's my parting gift to these amazing volunteers. Did I put up there?
What's mine in black and white?
I don't know. I thought you'd be more familiar with that. So as we move forward with Jalen and the amazing ways that he and the youth will find to serve in the future, I gathered some of the pictures of the past so we old people, especially Guy, can always find our way back to the light also. Always find our way back to the light. That reminds us that we are also cherished children of God. So,
take your books. Cry there.
No more tears. It is time to dance. We told you this might happen. So we're going to demonstrate, when I say we, I mean the youth, right up. We're going to show one of the ways we all got to a cheerful state to serve this week. So please stand and learn or relearn if you haven't remembered when we tortured you to this like 5 years ago. It's a dance that goes to Audio Adrenaline's Get Down. It's pretty simple and repetitive, so we invite you to join us in that.
Lives are wasted on the devil's level. may not have constant food on the table or clean clothes that fit. Call on us to help those who aren't as fortunate and volunteer us where you need us. Lead us to give cheerfully, whether it be through money, food, clothing that we may not need anymore, and help us to give wherever you need us to, whether that be at the ReStore with new doors or any sort of equipment that could be used, or giving clothing to the Methodist ReStore so that they can give it to those in need who can use it for the next school year when they're going to work. That way they aren't missing some school days because they don't have any clothes on their back that fit. Maybe you lead us to give food, something that can be stored and saved for people that need it most, and given out in the right times. Lead us where you need us, and keep you in our hearts, and everyone that may not be as fortunate as us in our hearts as well. In your name we pray, amen. And if you'll join me for the Lord's Prayer. Our Father,
deliver us from evil, for thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever.
ability to address them and to counter the forces that are part of our society are very serious. I also want to remember there is joy. There is joy in serving the Lord. So my second question to you is there joy in the Lord?
Yes.
I'm wondering if you could be even more enthusiastic. Is there joy in the Lord?
Yes.
There it is. So I send you forward with hope in your heart.
Left or center.
Joy.
Left or center.
In your life. Thanks be to God.